The hard cotton bob polishing technique is ideal for use on plain punch cups with medium to heavy scratching or pitting. Use it only on plain cups, not embossed cups. First, gather the tools you will need. The hard cotton bob, part MA5006. The abrasive dressing stick, part number 5010. The complete hand motor kit is part number MA5045 in the Natoli catalog.
What I'm going to do is take a tool that's been damaged on the inside, scratching or wear to the inside of the cup, and I'm going to smooth it out to try to get that luster finish back to that tool again.
You can see here the damage this aggressive technique can remove. First, you need to stone the tool using a 400 grit stone, part number MA5016, to remove nicks and burrs, restoring the land, which will strengthen the edge of the cup. Then start the process.
What I've got to do with the cotton bob, though, I've got to form it to the concavity of my tool.
Then use the abrasive dressing stick to begin to shape the bob to match the cup. The process will go quickly and can get messy.
By applying the dressing stone to the bob, moving it back and forth, you're cutting the bob, you're coming on the back side, cutting the bob, and what you're doing is forming the bob. Hit the face.
Move the tool back and forth over the stick, working to match the cup radius. The radius does not have to be perfect, but close to be effective.
As you can see, I've got it shaped to where it's going to fit inside my tool. It's got a nice radius on it to get down to the inside of the cup and the walls of the tool.
Next, the polishing begins. Turn the machine back on and apply the gray polishing compound, also known as the Gray Coarse Rouge Bar, part number MA5049 in the catalog. Apply the compound and work the bob through your cup. Using this compound with the cotton bob will remove heavy scratches on the surface of your tool.
I'm going to move the tool. I'm not going to move the bob. This keeps it nice and smooth.
Use light pressure on the tool. Let the bob and the compound do the work.
When using a bob, you don't want to overwork the tool.
When you feel you may be finished, wipe out the cup with a soft cotton towel and check your progress.
You can see that the finish is starting to get a luster finish back to it. There was some scarring on the walls of the tool. As you can see, they're starting to dissipate. When using this cotton bob, though, what you have to understand is, one, you want to stay away from the bottom of this cup as much as possible.
The results with this method can be quick and dramatic. The key is control. You don't want to overwork the tool and don't over-polish the bottom of the cup, because that can affect the critical working length. The hard cotton bob can have excellent outcomes for plain tools, including capsules and rounds.